Hello friends, through this video lecture we start our first topic of secretarial practice, introduction to corporate finance. The word corporate is derived from the Latin word corpus, means corporate just means as a body. So this word is derived from Latin word corpus, and the word finance is derived or originated from Latin word finis, means here the both two terms corporate and finance are originated from Latin word corpus and finis respectively. Next, introduction of topic. The term finance is related with the money, how we use money, how we raise money, how we generate money, means each and everything related with the money, and basically the money in relation with the requirement as a business, requirement as a capital for business firm. Here we discuss the term finance as a relation with the requirement of money for business purpose. So the finance is related with the money and management of money. The term finance is also related with the inflow and outflow of money. Inflow means how money comes into the business, and outflow means how the finance manager take various decision, that is investment decision, that is investment or outflow of money. So success of business firm is depends upon efficient use and generation of money. As Mr. Henry Ford rightly says, money is an arm or leg, either we use it or lose it. So this statement is enough sufficient to make more clarify the significance or importance of money or finance in as a business need. To do each and every activity or any activity in the business, we require some basic things. So money is one of the basic thing which we require to start or start any activity in business. Without finance or without money, the business or commencement of business is not possible. So corporate finance, next point, corporate finance, meaning corporate finance deals with raising and use of finance. Corporate finance deals with raising and use of finance, how the firm raise finance and how the firm use finance. There are two sources of raising of finance: own sources, OWNED, own sources, and borrowed sources. In own sources, there are equity shares, preference shares, and retained earnings. In borrowed sources, there are debentures, bonds, deposits, and loans. These are the instrument of borrowed sources. So the corporate finance also deals with the financial activities of corporation, such as capital structuring and investment decision. Capital, that is the amount invested by business owner in the business, known as a capital. And structure, that is arrangement of different components in proper proportion. So the capital structure constitutes two words, capital and structure. So the capital structure means arrangement of different financial instruments in proper proportion, that is capital structure. And investment decision, after raising of finance, the one of the thing, that is how the firm invest its money, in or how the corporate finance manager take decision regarding investment of money. Either they use money or invest money in fixed capital, or either they invest money in working capital, or some part of money in fixed capital, some part of money in working capital, and how much funds they remain with them as a reserve and surplus. So corporate finance also deals with the financial planning. Planning in ordinary means deciding in advance what is to be done in future, how it is to be done, when it is to be done, for whom it is to be done. So the financial planning means an advanced programming of financial decision and advanced programming of financial activities of any business firm, that is financial planning, study of capital market, money market, capital formation, and foreign capital. How company collect capital or raise finance from foreign institutions. So all these things we have to study as a topic of corporate finance. Next, role of finance manager regarding corporate finance. Firm has adequate finance means the corporate finance manager must ensure that the firm must have adequate finance, because each and every decision may be for expansion purpose, may be for production purpose, may be for selling distribution purpose. Each and every decision taken by finance manager and board of directors together with the secretary, while prior keep in mind availability of source of finance with them. Firm must use right source of finance having minimum cost, because there are two sources, own sources and borrowed sources. On borrowed sources, company must pay a compulsory payment of interest as a return on investment to that borrowed capital holder, which is fixed amount or fixed rate of interest the company which pay on the borrowed capital sources. So the cost of capital must be minimum, and company must earn the profit more than the cost of capital, because one of the aim of financial management is to maximize owner's wealth. Equity shareholders and preference shareholders are owners of the company. Equity shareholders are the real owners and controller of the company. So company must generate a maximum returns to its owners. So while taking investment decision, company must take investment decision in such a systematic manner that the firm must get more amount, more returns. Company must get more returns to pay a higher dividend, higher rate of dividend to its owners, or maximize returns to its owners. So this is the role of finance manager regarding corporate finance. Next, definition of corporate finance. Corporate finance deals primarily with the acquisition and use of capital by business corporation. Acquisition means raising of funds, acquiring of funds while with the help of various sources, and use of capital. Use of capital means how company use capital, how much company use in fixed assets, how much company remain with them as of working capital, how much company use for allocate funds for different departments of the organization. So using and acquisition of funds, these two things mainly consist in corporate finance, that is acquisition of funds and using of funds by business corporation. So this definition is given by Mr. Henry Hogland. कॉरपोरेट फाइनेंस इज द डिवीजन ऑफ फाइनेंस दैट डील्स विथ हाउ कॉरपोरेशंस डील्स विथ फंडिंग सोर्सेस कैपिटल स्ट्रक्चरिंग एज वी डिस्कस अर्लियर कैपिटल स्ट्रक्चर इन्वेस्टमेंट डिसीजंस आफ्टर रेजिंग फंड्स फर्स्ट कंपनी डिसाइड इट्स फाइनेंशियल नीड आफ्टर डिसाइडिंग और फोरकास्टिंग इट्स फाइनेंशियल नीड कंपनी डिसाइड सोर्सेस ऑफ फाइनेंस एंड आफ्टर डिसाइडिंग सोर्सेस ऑफ फाइनेंस कंपनी एक्चुअली रेज फाइनेंस फ्रॉम दीज सोर्सेस एज पर देयर रिक्वायरमेंट एंड आफ्टर रेजिंग फाइनेंस कंपनी मेक इन्वेस्टमेंट डिसीजन सो हाउ कंपनी मेक इन्वेस्टमेंट डिसीजन नेक्स्ट कॉरपोरेट फाइनेंस प्राइमरीली कंसर्न विद मैक्सिमाइजिंग शेयर होल्डर्स वैल्यू थ्रू लॉन्ग एंड शॉर्ट टर्म फाइनेंशियल प्लानिंग मैक्सिमाइजिंग शेयर होल्डर्स वैल्यू मीन्स लिसन द वैल्यू ऑफ इक्विटी शेयर और मार्केट वैल्यू ऑफ इक्विटी शेयर इज फ्रिक्वेंटली देर आर वेरियस चेंजेस और फ्लक्चुएशंस इन द मार्केट वैल्यू ऑफ इक्विटी शेयर्स बिकॉज मार्केट वैल्यू ऑफ इक्विटी शेयर्स इज डिपेंड अपॉन डिमांड सप्लाई फोर्सेस फॉर दैट पर्टिकुलर सिक्योरिटीज ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर कंपनी द टर्म सिक्योरिटी इंक्लूड्स ऑल टाइप्स ऑफ इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स शेयर्स डिबेंचर बॉन्ड्स बट हियर वी डील ओनली विद द इक्विटी शेयर्स आर वी टॉकिंग अबाउट ओनली विद द इक्विटी शेयर्स द मार्केट वैल्यू ऑफ इक्विटी शेयर्स इज depend upon demand supply forces for that particular share so market value is fluctuates or changeable change as per demand and supply for that particular share so when company's market values goes up so it is a good and I it is a remark for that company as a financially sound condition of that particular company a remark of financial sound condition of that company so company must get a return maximum return to its shareholders through long term and short term financial planning and implementation of various strategies corporate finance activities ranges from capital investment decision to investment banking also so primarily the corporate finance deals with raising of finance use of finance getting maximum returns to its shareholders company must ensure the shareholders that its market value if they invest funds in such a manner that their market value of their share must go up each and every time next point basis of corporate finance there are two basis of corporate finance financing decision and investment decision again the finance is defined as the management of money includes activities such as investing borrowing lending budgeting saving and forecasting investing means investment of money guntavne borrowing mhanje money dusryakadun karz swarupat ghene samjha tumcha ekada mitrakadun tumhi kahi karanani mitra jar kahi paise घेत असाल तर ते तुम्ही काहीतरी टर्म्स अँड कंडिशन्सवरती घेतलेले असतात की ते तुम्ही त्याला परत देणार असतात ते बॉरोइंग ऑफ मनी लेंडिंग ऑफ मनी यू लेंड मनी तुम्ही एखाद्याला कर्ज म्हणून पैसे देत असाल लेंडिंग ऑफ मनी बजेटिंग सेव्हिंग अँड फोरकास्टिंग सो देर आर टू बेसिस ऑफ कॉर्पोरेट फायनान्स फायनान्सिंग डिसिजन अँड इन्व्हेस्टमेंट डिसिजन firm has access capital markets to fulfill its financial needs a capital market is a market where long term debt and equity securities are bought and sold capital market is a place where long term debt and equity securities are bought and sold. So to fulfill the company's financial needs, corporate finance manager reach to the financial market to fulfill its financial needs. There is two types of sources of financing, as we already discussed, but I am repeating here: own sources and debt sources. Even the firm can raise finance from banks, loans, from bank loans, deposits as a source of funds. There must be a proper combination of debt capital and equity capital in the capital structure of that company. So these things include in the as a financing decision of the firm or business corporation. Next is investment decision. After forecasting financial need, after choosing right source of finance for that company, after choosing the right source, company raise finance from that sources, and after raising finance, the next and most important thing, that is investment decision. After collecting capital, business firm has to invest fund in such a systematic manner the returns generated from the investment must be maximum return to its owners. Firm must know its cost of capital to use funds most appropriate way to get return more than the cost of capital. Cost of capital means minimum return expected by investors. So when company know the cost of capital, that is minimum return expected by its investor, so company must earn profit or must earn return more than the cost of capital, means company have a sufficient fund to pay to its owners or to its finance those, or the funds have maximum amount with them to provide as a return to those who provide finance for the company. Capital market for long term debt instrument and equity shares. In this market, equity and debt instruments are issued and traded. Debt instruments includes debentures, bonds, deposits,